Good morning. I'm Dr. Sarah Bachar from Little Rock VA, Central Arkansas. I've been with the VA for about 25 years. I'm board certified in internal medicine, geriatrics, hospice, and palliative care medicine. Serving veterans who are 65 years and older, serving veterans with long-term illnesses, serving veterans who are towards the end of life. That's my profession, and I love my profession. Truly an honor to be here with all of you today. I would like to make three main points today. What's happening? There are too many prescriptions happening. What is not happening? There is no tool for deprescribing. What's happening? Prescriptions. What's not happening? Deprescribing. Yes, we need both folks who can prescribe, but we also need folks who can deprescribe. The world needs both optimists and pessimists. The optimist created the airplane and the pessimist created the parachutes. We do need deprescribers, and let's work together. So what is VIONE? It is an innovative deprescribing tool. It helps to manage persons on too many medications that cause more harm than helping the person. VIONE is our tool. The acronym stands for, is it vital? Is it important? Is it optional? No, it's not indicated. And does every medicine have a reason to be continued? What is deprescribing? Intentionally planning and stopping a medicine or reducing its dose. Why do we need to do that? Why do we need to describe, deprescribe? It is important sometimes to improve a person's health, to decrease the risk of adverse and undesirable side effects. What's the goal of deprescribing? We know prescribing is to treat a symptom, cure an illness. What's the goal of deprescribing? To better manage polypharmacy and to improve the health of a person. How did all this journey start? Over 2 years ago, I was working on a 15-bed inpatient subacute rehab unit. As we were getting more patients, most of them were from acute care, ER, surgery, post-operative, et cetera. They were so frail, they were getting repeated admissions, and quite a lot of the admissions and illnesses were related to medication-related side effects. How realistic are we? This is a 91-year-old veteran, has Alzheimer's dementia, had strokes, was confined to bed, unable to care for himself, caregiver is stressed, 6th admission in the past year. He's supposed to also take 4 injections, and he was also taking some over-the-counter medications. Right off the bat, some of the medications were stopped. However, each time he was getting discharged and going home, there was not enough communication. He started taking the same medications all over again. And then he was coming back to the ER again. This is a visual of the medications he was supposed to take, this 91-year-old person, AM and PM. Thanks to my son, who actually helped create this visual for me. We need them too. So in between all these injections and medications and a stressed out caregiver and a bed confined person, how realistic are we? We are not realistic. So what did we do? Right off the bat, we took off some medications, and actually we cleaned up a little bit, then we had to work together as a team. 8 months later, this is how his profile looked like. Thank you. It is doable, we can do it, we have to do it, and we have to gain the momentum. We created CPRS tools, it is embedded, it's a long journey, but we are here to work. We did all the hard work, we ironed out many wrinkles, the kit is ready to be imported and exported. So this veteran was approaching end of life, improved quality of life, he was just on 5 medications. Again, before, after. This is innovation, this is implementation, this is seeing your ideas come to action. I was curious, I started asking our veterans, I too like stories, I too like to talk. So what my patients say, I don't like some of my pills, they make me sick. Nobody asks me if I take my medications. They just send the refills. They just keep sending more. I have many pill bottles that I never open. I don't know why and how I should take these medicines. I know I should take them, but I don't. They are too expensive. I cannot afford them. Meet Mark. Mark was 61 years old when he came. His wife, she had her own health issues. She loved him dearly. However, she could not take care of Mark because he was just sitting in the chair or lying down in the bed, and he just could not afford the care that he needed. So he was admitted to our locked dementia unit. He was stuporous. He was just sitting there. He would be drooling, and over a period of 4 months, we stopped his Ativan, we stopped his Seroquel, we stopped his Xanax, we stopped his Trazodone, and Mark, what happened? I need Mark. Okay, we need Mark back, please. So Mark, while they are getting Mark back to us, Mark stood up, he woke up. Actually, he was sharing his stories. He started singing. With the help of a good therapist, he stood up. Now that he was walking in the hallways, he wanted to wear bright color shirts. He wanted his shoes on. It was unbelievable. It was really like seeing a true miracle unfold in front of us. I called Mark's wife and said that Mark is walking now. She said, Dr. Bettar, I appreciate the call, but I think you're talking about the wrong patient. I said, no, it's Mark. And I gave her the history, how we were working on stopping the medications and how, about our discussions. She just cried. With her consent, I took a picture and sent her the picture. She wrote a beautiful letter. She said, I keep Mark's picture on my fridge. He's my baby. I talk to him every day. I forgot how Mark would look if he were standing up. I forgot that Mark was 6 feet 2 inches tall. So this is Mark. And from being confused and chair-bound, he was just walking and joking and singing. How many is too many? Currently, nearly half of men and two-thirds of women over 65 in US are on 5 or more medications, which is one of the definitions for polypharmacy. Medications are not safe all the time. Yes, we require them, but they are not safe all the time. This is a visual I created. There are so many side effects and increased medication errors. Health literacy is not just knowing about the disease, but knowing how to navigate through the system. Increased pill burden, adverse effects from drug-drug interactions, more ER visits, hospitalization, increased financial burden, non-compliance, lower quality of life. These are potentially inappropriate medications. Quite a lot of discussion is happening. There are many field champions. We are building a coalition. We are building a community of practice, so all of us, like-minded professionals with similar interests who believe in creating some deprescribing tools, we are working together. VIONE stands for vital. Is this medication life-saving? Is it critical? You must have it. You cannot afford to stop it. Okay, continue that. Is it important? It's good for quality of life. It might not save your life, but your pain, your constipation, your dry skin, that is important for your quality of life. Keep it. Optional, not a big deal really whether you take it or whether you stop it, so why take it? Not indicated, we see so many patients, albumin of 1.1, malnourished, lost 40 pounds, not taking medicines, still on simvastatin 80 milligrams, 6 days closer to death. That is where we have some potential to make a difference. Every medicine has a diagnosis that both the doctor, the prescribers, and the patients know. So from idea to action, in one medical center, over a period of 2.5 years, almost 8,000 veterans were impacted. We deprescribed 13,270 prescriptions. That is awesome, isn't it? And that is so doable. All we need is a core group of committed individuals and something like diffusion of excellence to help us share our stories and propagate it. We saved over $2.327 million annualized cost avoidance dollars. On an average, it turns up to be 1.7 treatments reduced per person. There were no bad outcomes to date. What are some of the veterans saying? I thought I was going to have to live the rest of my life in a horrible state. Every provider I went to see just added more and more medications. I felt only worse and worse with each additional pill. You guys have given me my life back and new hope for what lies ahead. Thank you so much. Seriously, are you saying I can come off some of my medications? That never happened before. I'm getting a promotion. I can't wait to tell my wife. So gaining momentum, this is to date, over 26 VA medical centers have requested and we shared our information with them. And so how do we know how many is too many? Somebody we know, or it could be ourselves. Are we seeing numerous specialists? Are we taking multiple medicines? Are we having a hard time managing our medicines? Are we uncomfortable talking with our doctors? Are we taking more medicines than our doctor prescribed but didn't tell the doctor? Let's start working together to deprescribe. Use VIONE, a simple tool to help deprescribe. Please email us at vavion@va.gov. We'll get to you right away. We have a national coalition. We are working with PBM, and we are working with many other like-minded field champions. We have a toolkit, brochures, and we are on the Pulse page. We are all eager to work with you. Thank you for this opportunity.